So I just had to make this video in response to the bullshit video that I saw from this young lady who was just reporting on the findings of a test from the Laboratory of Atmospheric and Space Physics at the University of Colorado, which is basically a test they did on the trajectory of the moon dust that was kicked off from the rover. So they are saying that it's proof that the rover was on the moon and not on Earth because the way that the dust was kicked in the air. And I'm gonna prove that this is pure bullshit.
Conspiracy theorists have come up with some pretty interesting and creative explanations as to why we didn't land on the moon. There's some evidence that we landed on the moon that you can't disprove. Evidence like the way the dust flies in the wake of the lunar rovers. Footage from Apollo 16's so-called Lunar Rover Grand Prix shows astronauts John Young and Charlie Duke roving around the moon in the second lunar rover to reach the surface. Some of the footage gives us a view of the dust kicked up by the rover's wheel, and the dust follows a trajectory it just couldn't follow if this Lunar Rover Grand Prix had been filmed on a soundstage on Earth. If you look at the way the dust is kicked up in the wake of the lunar rover's wheels, it forms a very distinctive rooster tail. It doesn't just fall in a parabolic arc like it would on Earth. The rooster tail is a product of the lunar environment, the low gravity environment and the lack of appreciable atmosphere. There's nothing to drag the dust particles down. They're able to fly further from the rover's wheels after being kicked up in the air, and they follow a spinning trajectory thanks to the wheel's movements. We just wouldn't see this on Earth. The atmosphere causes enough friction with dust particles that anything kicked up behind a vehicle would just fall straight back down again. This is actually a really interesting way to prove that we did land on the moon, and possibly one of the hardest ones to disprove. This study was done by two scientists at the Laboratory for Atmospheric and Space Physics at the University of Colorado in Boulder. They turned the trajectory of the dust that they saw in the Lunar Rover Grand Prix footage into a mathematical formula, and when they replaced the lunar values for earthly values, what they saw was that the footage could not have possibly been filmed on Earth. The dust just wouldn't act the same way. According to the math, dust on the Earth cannot fly like it does in the lunar rover footage.
So they're saying that the lunar rover footage, the dust that kicks up off the wheels, is unique to the moon and cannot be found on Earth.
The lunar rover's wheels, it forms a very distinctive rooster tail. It doesn't just fall in a parabolic arc like it would on Earth.
So they're saying that on the moon, it forms a rooster tail effect. While on Earth, it would be a parabolic arc effect. So you'll notice when we look at the rover, look at the dust trail behind it. You'll notice how it kicks up like a rooster tail, but it's forming like a backward C, which is in the same shape as the tire.
There's nothing to drag the dust particles down. They're able to fly further from the rover's wheels after being kicked up in the air, and they follow a spinning trajectory thanks to the wheel's movements. We just wouldn't see this on Earth. The atmosphere causes enough friction with dust particles that anything kicked up behind a vehicle would just fall straight back down again.
Now, obviously, sand is much heavier than dust. The grains of sand are much larger than the particles of dust, which is like a powder. So let's take a look at some heavier sand here on Earth being kicked up by the sand dune buggies. And as we watch the footage, and we'll watch it in slow-mo right now, but you're going to see the exact same C shape that we saw in the lunar footage. And this is sand, which is even much heavier than the so-called lunar dust.
The rooster tail is a product of the lunar environment, the low gravity environment and the lack of appreciable atmosphere. There's nothing to drag the dust particles down. They're able to fly further from the rover's wheels after being kicked up in the air, and they follow a spinning trajectory thanks to the wheel's movements. We just wouldn't see this on Earth.
Now, you'll notice how they have this footage slowed down. This is not normal speed whatsoever. They're wanting you to think it is, but it's not. This is a closer representation of real time.
Even though
What they saw was that the footage could not have possibly been filmed on Earth. The dust just wouldn't act the same way. According to the math, dust on the Earth cannot fly like it does in the Lunar Rover footage.